he says, heaven, this is what he says about heaven. He says that the Bible speaks of the collapse of the existing world order and the arising of a new heaven and a new earth. We need to understand here that heaven is not a location, but refers to the inner realm of consciousness. This is the esoteric meaning of the word, and also the teachings of Jesus. Wow. Earth is the outer manifestation in form, which is always a reflection of the inner. A new heaven is the emergence of a transformed state of human consciousness, and a new earth is a reflection in the physical form. So essentially what he's saying is that heaven is not a location, but that heaven and eternal life are within us. And it's the inner consciousness that once we're awakened to our Godhood, then we'll transform the earth, which is the outer form, the manifestation of the inner self. And so basically, well, you know what we see with Tolle, obviously he's twisting the scriptures. I mean, is this how Jesus described heaven? And Jesus, that is just a kind of coming of age of consciousness. But basically what we see is he's twisting the scripture completely out of context to suit his own misguided ideas. And it's really interesting when he quotes that verse that he conveniently left out the verse that precedes the verse that he quoted and named his book after, which basically says this: and whosoever was not found written in the book of life was cast in the lake of fire.
Fire.
Conveniently left that one out.
Sure did.
And neither does he discuss 2 Peter 3:13, which states that God prepares a place wherein dwells righteousness. So why would he leave that out? Because the opposite of righteousness is what?
Wickedness.
Is unrighteousness, right? And in his worldview of moral relativity, that doesn't fit in.
Right.
And of course, nowhere in Tolle's book does he talk about godliness, holiness, righteousness, nothing like that.
No.
But you know, Jesus did clearly state that heaven is a place, and he's gone to prepare a place for us. It's a place, not a so-called state of consciousness,
right.
But so Tolle basically is misguiding, misleading people by twisting the scripture.
Amen. Cult leader.
He's a cult leader, that's right. Go ahead. So he said basically that we kind of compare what the Bible says with what Tolle says. Of course, God in the Bible is not an it, he's not a force, he's not an impersonal force, but God is a personal being, has a mind, right? He has will and feeling. We have a relationship with him when we come to repentance and saving faith in Jesus Christ. He's the eternal Son of God. He's not a force to be manipulated like Tolle would have you believe. But God is also both immanent and transcendent, which means that God and creation are separate. It's a dualism, it's not a monism. And he is not the creation, nor is the creation in him. And he not only created all time, space, and matter, but he holds it all together. And he transcends beyond time, space, and matter. Where Tolle would have the worldview of a monism, that everything is within this one system. And in that systematic type of view of theology, there's no such thing as a miracle, because a miracle would say that there's a God that transcends the laws of nature, that intervenes, can split the Red Sea, can do all these things. In his worldview, there can never be a miracle, because everything is within the system of nature, and all we have to do is to manipulate these laws or forces to cause things to happen. So we can part the Red Sea. It's just a matter of manipulating the natural laws that run the universe. Of course, the Bible says also that God is infinite, he's timeless, he's a changeless being, he's an infinite being, he's self-existent, timeless, versus creation, which is finite. And God is pure actuality, he has no potentiality. For the I am the Lord that I do not change. So we say God is infinite by nature, that any attribute that God has, he has it to an infinite degree. If God is knowing, then he's all-knowing, because he's an infinite God. If God is present, he's ever-present. And if he's a moral being, then God is infinitely moral without spot or blemish.
Amen.
Because if he lacked any of these attributes, he would have a finite attribute, and that would disqualify him from being an infinite God.
Amen.
And so, is pure actuality. Basically, what we're saying is that God could, there's nothing that God could ever do to increase his potential in anything. In other words, God could never increase his potential to learn more or or to be more powerful, or to be more holy, because he's infinite and he has no potentiality to increase. And there are actually people that out there that teach that God doesn't know the future. I mean, how do you think about this? How can this is within evangelicals? I mean, how could God know, who created the finite universe, who transcends it, not know the future of this finite thing that would limit his understanding of what he created? And so basically what then we see Tolle right here, what Tolle is doing, he's saying the ego is your problem. This ego is the great enemy to attaining the enlightenment. And this ego basically he defines as our thinking. The ego is the rational thought, and which he calls the ego. And so he says, at the heart of the new conscience lies the transcendence of thought, a newfound ability rising above thought, of realizing a dimension within yourself that is infinitely more vast than thought. Ego is identification with form, so which spiral means thought forms. So this results in a total unawareness of my connectedness with the whole, so my intrinsic oneness with every other as well as the source. And so here he goes on, he says that an essential part of the awakening is the recognition of the unawakened you, the ego as it thinks, speaks, and acts, as well as the recognition of the collectively conditioned mental process that perpetuate the unawakened state. So in other words, he's saying that we need to realize that our ego or our thoughts are the unawakened part of us. Not only as individuals, but as a collective consciousness, we need to see a mass awakening, so this way we can bring in this new world order, we can bring in this age of Aquarius. And that's primarily the goal of the occult in the new age, is to bring about a transcendent consciousness, to bring in a new world order. And they want to bring it in not only religiously, where you have a one world religion, but they want to bring it in governmentally, where you have a one world government. And in other areas. So it's going to be kind of a triad type of, or tripod type of system that's really the goal of the occult. And it's kind of interesting because Lysistrata, which was founded by Alice Bailey, a theosophist, she was a very well-known occultist with Lysistrata. Basically, she founded Lucifer's Trust, which they renamed Lysistrata. But basically, that's kind of the whole idea that they put behind the New World Order. And they've been writing about this through other people as well. And to be awakened, but it's, their awakening is to get rid of the idea of sin, of a moral law, and to transcend above all that type of stuff.
Yeah.
And so basically we're just an awakened part of us, we need to wake up. So this is the solution that Tolle says, is just don't think about it, just go deep. So he says, don't seek to grasp it with your mind. Don't try to understand it. You can know it only when the mind is still, when you are present, when your attention is fully and intensely in the now. Being can be felt, but it can never really be understood mentally. So, basically, we don't try to grasp it. Just stop our thinking. Just feel. Just be. Just experience it. Just because... this trying to think things out is really the root of the ego, which is really the problem, which is keeping you from transcending in your consciousness. And so this is basically what we call mysticism. And mysticism is basically the doorway into the occult.
Yep.
And when you get into the occult, you get into mystical practices, which is letting go of the mind and trying to transcend. And there's a lot of different forms they do this. Good.